Hello everyone, Jambo and greetings from Kenya. I am in Nairobi, an important hub of trade, technology, finance and culture for all of East Africa. And I'm always astonished by the city's rapid pace of change and growth. Still, it has maintained its warmth, its energy, its dynamism, which make it so special. The diversity of my engagement during this trip truly reflects the diversity of the Kenyan economy. People from the digital world, from housing, from pharmaceutical, from food, from power sectors, business leaders, and creative industries. It really shows that Kenya is a hub and an essential part of the African regional integration. President Kenyatta was very kind to give us some of his time to meet and discuss his Big Four. Big Four are the strategy and reform around which he has organized the economic program of Kenya. And IFC was a key participant in helping in the implementation of these priorities. COVID-19 reminded us that economies need to be resilient. Kenya was among those countries which were able to face this crisis and to respond to it in a very effective manner. But he had put pressure on the budget. Now, more than ever, we need to bring the private sector at the center of the work we are doing in Kenya. Luckily, the country has all the ingredients to have the private sector-led growth that we want to see on the continent. Africa Trade Agreement offers us an opportunity to integrate even more African economies, to specialize it more to be able to bring competitiveness for the continent. We have seen also a lot of innovation. We have seen disruptive technology being developed here. I visited one of our clients, Twiga, who is really innovating in terms of logistics, in terms of investment in the food industry, and in terms of using technology. But Kenya was not the only country I visited during this trip. I went also to Tanzania. I had an opportunity to meet the new president and a cabinet. We discussed how IFC can be playing a bigger role in Tanzania. She asked us to be the main agent to support the agenda she has in economic empowerment and development for women in Tanzania. So we are taking this challenge, and you will see more and more of our interventions being centered around gender activities. So goodbye for now, and
Kwaheri.